In the latest news regarding a recent Qatari hack of American officials, it seems that outgoing United States Ambassador Nikki Haley may hold the key to prosecution and the pursuit of justice.
In late September, it was revealed by former Republican National Committee Vice Chair Elliot Broidy and his legal team that Qatar had orchestrated a massive hack targeting over 1,200 people, including Broidy himself and dozens of other high-ranking officials in American politics, the CIA, the United Arab Emirates, Egypt, Qatar, and more. According to Broidy's attorney Lee Wolowski, even Bollywood stars like Aishwarya Devan and Anushka Sharma were hit, suggesting perhaps a, quote, frolic of the hackers, end quote. But when Qatar was awarded sovereign immunity in the case last month, Broidy's legal team changed focus in its litigation towards Jamal Ben Omar, who is accused to have allegedly orchestrated the Qatari attack. Ben Omar is a longtime UN official and Moroccan national, however, and he has also now applied for retroactive immunity as a Moroccan diplomat, which brings us to Ambassador Haley. As the United States' ambassador to the UN, Haley has the power to decide whether or not to grant diplomatic immunity retroactively to Ben Omar. And already, many are begging Haley not to cave into political pressures. Greg Roman, director of the Middle East Forum, said that Jamal Ben Omar, who is the alleged leader of a cyber espionage campaign targeting and attacking Americans, quote, should face these charges in court. Allowing diplomatic immunity to be abused in this way sets a dangerous precedent for our country that puts all U.S. citizens at risk, end quote. Haley's office has not yet been reached for comment.